Good morning, everyone. I'm Jennifer Castro. I'm the Business Intelligence Head of Millennials under Joy Nostalg Group. So my short talk is about the third letter in our Christ should value, which is responsibility. So let's start my presentation entitled Taking Charge, Millennials and Gen Z Participation in the Age of Pandemic. As you can see, we have three key words or phrases here. First is taking charge or take charge, which is our what, and then millennials and Gen Z as our who, and the sobering why, the pandemic, which we are facing right now, the COVID-19 pandemic. So, okay, first we define our what. So responsibility comes from the Latin word respondere, meaning to respond. A simple definition from the dictionary says that it has to be in charge of something as part of one's job, answerable to, and being accountable. Okay, so, but what does it look like in the workplace? So, what is it? Okay, so, first, a duty that or task that you are required or expected to perform. Okay, so responsibility is the state or fact of being accountable to for a duty or task that you are required or expected to perform. In the workplace, responsibility is required in many areas. Or job, duties, corporate guidelines, security, privacy, etc. So all of them seem slightly different, but they all center on you, on us, knowing and following these guidelines and being accountable for our actions. So frequently, your responsibilities as they pertain to you fulfilling the duties of your job are outlined to you in a document or by your superior or by the human resources. However, this is the letter B, personal responsibility. It's the way you respond to a certain situation that is your choice. Okay? So, frequently, your responsibilities or personal responsibility is not clearly or neatly outlined kasi it's nga personal na nga. So, responsibility can be thought as the way you respond to a certain situation. How you respond is your choice. And the next one is accountability or taking ownership of your decisions and output regardless of outcome. So the accountability aspect of responsibility means you take ownership of the outcome of your choices, whether good or bad. When you conduct yourself with personal responsibility and accountability, you build, number one, integrity. So, and with integrity comes trust and respect. So both internally and externally. Of course, when it's within you, innate in you, people will see it and eventually, di ba? If you fake it, you cannot fake it for a long time. If people will eventually find out, and you yourself will not be able to keep up with all the lies or with all the ano mo yung ingenuity na pinapakita mo sa mga tao. Okay. So before I go to the why, why is responsibility important to the workplace? Let us first have a review on our second keyword or phrase, the who, the millennials and Gen Z. Okay, so the next slide will show you the Venn diagram of the generational similarities and differences of millennials and Gen Z. So millennials are born between 1981 to 1996. So the oldest millennial is about 40 years old and the youngest is 25 years old. Okay, so the millennials or us millennials, we embrace technology. And we still recall the dial-up internet. Okay, so we want a job with an opportunity for growth. However, we have this tendency to have this instant gratification and recognition because we grew up in social media platforms, we grew up with the internet, we grew up with access to digital information and data. However, on the good side, we are civic-oriented. Okay, so most of the time, we want to give back to the community, to help other people, to help people whom we think are less on the less privileged side, something like that. And we are also optimistic or idealistic. Okay, however, on the other side, the Gen Z, they are born between 1997 to 2012. So the oldest generation Z is about 24 years old, and the youngest is 9 years old. Okay, so the Gen Z are the first digital natives. So they don't know a world wherein technology does not exist because when they were born, there's already internet, there's already access to digital information. There's cell phones, there's data plan on our mobile phones, and they are born into a world with ample technology, as I've mentioned earlier. And unlike millennials, who wanted a growth for a job with a growth opportunity, the Gen Z are focused on personal connections, and they prefer more face-to-face communication. So millennials are civic-oriented, the Gen Z are authentic. So for example, the millennial, they are civic-oriented, they want to give back to the community, and they support brands or they support companies that reflect their values and whom they believe that the company is doing good for the community. However, the Gen Z, they are authentic, meaning whatever reflects their authenticity, regardless if it's aligned with the social norms or not, they will go for it. Okay, so the millennials are the more idealistic one, optimistic, and the Gen Z are the pragmatic ones. They are practical. Okay, so more often than not, their social, what do you call this, their social norms, they have a tendency to compromise it because they think that to each his own, something like that. Okay, and so with this, the two generations who are both tech savvy, these are the similarities. These two generations are both tech savvy. They want to be difference makers. However, they have this corporate skepticism, and they have this personal responsibility, high personal responsibility. We are on the individualistic side, but at the same time, we are collaborative. So we are this. We are on a collaborative side, but at the same time, we can work on our own. We are also independent. And we have this entrepreneurial thinking. So millennials' use of technology clearly sets them apart. Millennials and Gen Z, our use of technology clearly sets us apart. Okay, so one of the defining characteristics of our generations is our affinity with the digital world. Okay, so just to support this information, this Venn diagram, I've searched into a study done by the PwC. They are one of the globally recognized professional companies who conduct surveys on young professionals on different companies worldwide. Okay, so in 2011, they conducted among 4,364 respondents across 75 countries. So all of these respondents are below 31 years old. Okay, so 2011, during that time, I'm a fresh graduate. Pero di man ako nasama sa survey. So during that time, when the 2010, early 2000, yung millennial na term, it's a big parang concept to people and to companies because they have this new set of employees that are very different from the Generation X or the boomers or the silent generation. Okay, so 75% of millennials, so these are the results of the survey. Okay, so I just picked up three among all the others. So 75% of millennials believe that they will have 2 to 5 employers during their lifetime. So 75% of millennials believe that they will have 2 to 5 employers during their lifetime or during their professional career. So this is prevalent because we can see that in our generation, the millennials and Gen Z, we have a tendency to jump ship from one company to another when we see that that we are not experiencing growth or we are somehow, alam mo yun, yung nakaklip yung wings mo to explore and to improve your craft or your career, your chosen field. So they said that they will have 2 to 5 employers in their lifetime. And they also, the survey also said that millennials place more importance on work-life balance than financial compensation. Okay, and 41% prefer to communicate through electronical means rather than face-to-face or the telephone. Okay, so I think on the work-life balance because millennials now, during that time in 2011, the ones that they conducted are all 31 years old and below. So, parang ano na to eh, parang ano na siya, halo-halong factors na rin, di ba? Kasi right now, people are more career-driven. They tend to marry late. So they want to have, they want to explore things. Since wala pa naman silang family, they want to travel. They want to do other hobbies. They want to kumbaga, to develop themselves. They want to enroll to other courses, online courses, or even graduate school programs, something like that. So they want to have, for example, if our work is 9 to 6, as much as possible, I get to finish everything at 9 to 6 and then extend a little bit and then I will do whatever I want, like my hobbies or the other classes that I have enrolled to. Okay, and then the 41% that they prefer to communicate, yun nga, because I mentioned earlier that we are born into digital world. We are already tech savvy. So most of the information or most of the time, we tend to communicate through our phones. Kasi nga, parang, kumbaga yung, we make use of the technology that we have. Diba? Technology is there to make our lives easier. Yun yung ideal. Okay? So in 2016, ang sabi ng survey, in 2016, millennials became the largest generation in the labor force. And this will be supported, kumbaga, this is the macro scale, and then I will also share a bit of information in the micro scale on our company naman. Okay, so in 2018, oldest Gen Z started working, making these two tech-savvy generations influence how the platform is changing already. Okay? Okay, so I've discussed the micro level. Now we go to the micro level naman. Okay? So here in Joy Nostalg, particularly in Raymolan Lands, our workforce is at 532 people. Ayan. Okay. So as you can see, my simple graph lang dito. So our workforce in Raymolan Lands is 532 regular employees. So as you can see, for those aged 20 to 25, 35 years old, which are in the millennials and the Generation Z, it comprises of 318 employees, or it makes up to our 60% of labor force. Okay, so nung mga bata-bata pa ako, mga early 20s, nakwento ko na to before, I think, na nung pumasok ako sa company, ako yung pinakabata. Tapos, iniisip ko, darating naman din yung time na magkakaroon na rin ng mga maraming mas bata pa sa akin, at yun na yung magkukumpara, kumbaga yung magiging base ng company are mostly in the early 20s. So, nangyari na nga siya ngayon sa company natin. 60% of our workforce are already millennials and Gen Z. Okay, so 36 to 45 on the Generation X side, they are the 23% of our workforce, and mostly I think these are our VPs, our AVPs, and the 46 to 55 years old, this is our VPs as well, mga SVP, EVPs, ganyan. Okay, so now that we know and we have discussed the characteristics of these two tech-savvy generations, and what does responsibility look like in the workforce as we have in the workplace as we have experienced it, and now that we have come and we have delved into the micro level, which is in our company, so kumbaga mas maging ano tayo, mas maging talagang first hand yung pagtalakay natin. So with our 60% Generation Z and Millennials, so the question now is, how do we keep them? How do you keep us? Parang ganun. How do we keep each other? Parang ganun. Kasi meron din naman, I believe, na meron ng mga millennials and generation, mga millennials na mga unit heads, team leaders, ganyan. So for those people that have been entrusted with us, who work for us, how do we keep them? And to our management on a bigger scale, how do we keep these people, the 60%, to be motivated, to be encouraged, to deliver excellent outputs, and hindi sila mag-jump ship. Kasi sayang naman na yung tinrain natin sa kanila, sayang na yung in-invest natin time sa kanila, sayang na yung tinuro natin sa kanila. And kung may potential naman, di ba, why not build from ground up? Okay, so these are the few things that I've learned through the years. I've also read in some of the research and ano, kumbaga may experience na rin nakasama dito. Okay, so in the Q&A later, if you have some additional information, you can say them and we can alam mo yun, batuhan ng information and data. Okay, so number one is to give them rewards. So benefits and incentives. Not just on the monetary, but also number two, continuous learning. So diba, lalo na nag-start ako, I also want more than the money, yung mentorship. Because I want to build my skills, I want to build my character, and I want to, alam mo yun, yung kumbaga may ibubuga ka, hindi ka ampaw. So yun din yung ginagawa ko, I think, naman sa mga people who have been entrusted under me, yung mentorship and training and development. So training and development, it has to be collaboration with the company, because as a head, as a unit head, you can only do so much, but on the bigger scale, di ba, kailangan na din i-involve sila sa mga projects and programs ng company, which we have naman. Okay? And yung sense of community. So, more than nga, yung pag nag-start ka sa work, more than the monetary incentive, value, syempre mahalaga din yun. Mahalaga din yung may natututunan ka, yung hindi ka stagnant sa ginagawa mo, and yung may sense of community ka, kumbaga belong ka dun sa company, yung culture, na i-imbibe mo siya, align ka rin sa values ng company, kumbaga hindi ka lost, hindi ka naliligaw. Kasi malakas yung sense of community ng mga millennials and Gen Z. Once they feel that, once they know that they are heard, that they are seen, that their voice matter, they will deliver results and output that is more than expected of them. That's tried and tested. Okay? Because we can see our purpose and our values are aligned with the company. More, parang pag nakakausap ko din yung mga staff namin, yung mga friends ko din, ganyan, they, pag mababa, mag-transfer sila ng company, they take into consideration yung ano ba yung pinaglalaban ng kumpanya, ano ba yung mga values ng company, ano ba yung parang ano ba yung nagagawa ng kumpanya, because we want to have an employer that we can be proud of. Okay? So for example, may experience kang masama sa smoking, for instance. So you wouldn't want to go to a tobacco company, something like that. And kung nakikita mo naman na yung sense of community sa company that we are in now, for example, that we serve the Filipinos who want to have their own homes. So it's a big deal. Kumbaga, hindi lang siya pera-pera. May fulfillment ka nakukuha. And your values are aligned with the values of the company. What you believe in. Kasi diba ang hirap naman magtrabaho kung di mo pinaniniwalaan yung pinaniniwalaan ng kumpanya mo. Diba? Kasi it's always upward, diba? So on an individual, on yourself, on individual scale, it has to be a mirror of the corporation, of what the values of the corporation. Okay? So next, so earlier we discussed, diba, what does it look like in the workplace and what is responsibility? So now, why is it important naman? We go to the why. Diba? Why responsibility is important. So number one, because it drives results and leads to a functioning corporation. Okay? And kanina, the what of the personal responsibility, this is the why of the personal responsibility naman. It is a major component of character development. And on the what of the accountability, we're mirroring the why of the accountability and how it works in the workplace, diba? Investing in your work and holding yourself accountable will transform the way you deliver output. So, gusto ko lang i-relate dun sa Gen Z and the millennials, our two tech-savvy generations, when something is assigned to us and we are held accountable to it, more likely, dahil trabaho mo yun, you owned it, you will, alam mo yun, parang hindi ka magsasubmit ng basta-basta lang. kasi alam mo na trabaho mo siya. It mirrors your character. It mirrors who you are as a person or as an employee. Ganon. So, parang share ko lang din. Napansin ko din ito sa sarili ko na when I'm given more responsibility and nakikita ko yung gravity ng impact ng report na yon. So, gagawin mo talaga siya na masinsinan at gagawin mo na matatapos mo siya within the deadline at makakapag-present ka ng added value dun sa report mo. Unlike, nung siguro, nung, tsaka ano din, kasama rin siguro sa maturity, nung mas bata-bata ka, na since pakiramdam mo, ito lang muna yung ginagawa mo, ah, okay lang kasi hindi naman ako yung magre-report and all. But, it's a good thing that my mentors before, they decided to give me additional tasks and they've entrusted me reports or tasks that I can call my own, na yung template galing sa akin, it gives me a fulfillment on my work and yung ownership of the report. Kasi mas gagawin mo siya na mas maayos dahil alam mo na yun yung reflection of your work and of your character as well. Okay? So, how can I practice responsibility in the workplace naman? So, we've discussed the what, the why, and who are the people involved in this, alam mo yun, in this tripartite collaboration. Okay? So, how can I practice responsibility in the workplace? How can we practice responsibility in the workplace? Okay? So, I think, okay, responsibility is not just a value but a skill.
Mm-mm. Next slide.
Yes, next slide, please.
Okay.
Mm-mm. Okay. So we've discussed responsibility for the longest time as a value, but let me say that it's also a skill that you can practice every day by thinking about your actions and responses and taking accountability for the consequences of your choices, whether good or bad. So when you have this, when you have this sense na, oh, whatever happens, I will be accountable to it. So I will make sure that I will stand by my decision. So if you are standing by your decision, di ba, more highly likely naman, you'll do whatever the, yung mga supporting details or instructions before arriving to that decision. Okay? And also, if I may say, if you are already ahead, you don't, alam mo yun, wag mong nilalaglag yung mga tao around you. So it's better to, alam mo yun, to keep it all in. Kung mapapagalitan ka, hindi mapapagalitan ka, pero wag mong sasabihin na, ah, kasi po, si ganito, ganyan, ganyan. Lalo na kung parang mapapasama pa yung tao mo. So syempre, hindi ganun. So, as a head, kaya ka nga nandyan eh. It's for you to bear the brunt, whatever happens. Kasi, dapat chinek mo siya, or dapat mas nagawa mo na maayos. Diba? So, on my personal experience, ganun din yung ginagawa ng mentors ko, even nung bata-bata pa ako, diba? And up to now din naman, and I also do that to the people around me, na I make sure na you have to be on charge, you have to be on top of everything, don't leave any stone unturned, so that, kung alam mo yun, kung wala talaga, mapapagalitan talaga kayo kasi meron ka talaga na miss out, it's your responsibility and accountability as a leader. And then, saka mo nakakausapin yung mga staff mo na, oh, ganito nangyari sa akin kanina, ganito nangyari dun sa report natin, blah, 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 blah. So that you can improve all together as a team. Okay? So these are just, four practical tips that I've acquired through the years of based on experience din, ganyan. So, to practice responsibility every day in the workplace. So aside from thinking first before reacting and responding, so this will help us to, alam mo yun, to lessen yung bearing the brunt nga kapag may mga nangyayari sa office. Okay? So number one, know your job and do it well. So it's not wrong or it doesn't mean that you are weak when you ask questions. Dapat komportable ka na magtanong at mag-question kung hindi mo naiintindihan or kung meron ka nakikita na para mas mai-improve mo yung process or kung meron parang questionable dun sa process, don't hesitate to ask and to clarify. because it's better that way kesa forever mong ginagawa na pala yung isang task tapos mali pala. Kumbaga sayang lang effort, sayang yung time. Okay, number two, consider options before responding. So ito nga, kumbaga you have to pause muna. Diba? So for myself, I do is pause and pray. So if ever mataas ang emotion ko, I don't blurt out right away or shout right away. I think first, I like to calm myself first and then I get back to them pag medyo okay na ako. Isa talaga din maiwasan na namingit din ng ulo mo. So parang try to be calm muna. Kasi ikaw din eh, mahirap ma-hide lahat. Parang gano'n. Bata pa tayo. At may pandemic pa. So mahirap. Hindi kakayanin ng mga hospital na mag-ana tayo. Sumama pa tayo dun sa mga nasa waitlist. And number three, manage, motivate your team. Okay? So it's important that as a leader, you know how to manage your millennial staff, your Gen Z staff, and how to motivate them. Kasi based on experience din, they will always deliver what is asked of them. And kaya talagang, alam mo yun, kaya nila mag-multitask, makagawa ng paraan na mas madali, makaisip ng mas madali. Kasi nga, they know how to alam mo yun, they know how to deal with technology on their favor. On our favor. Diba? We have different apps na aware tayo that will make our lives easier. And we also have different, alam mo yun, skills na na-acquire na natin through the years. Na kahit hindi siya tinuro sa school, dahil lagi tayong nagla-laptop, lagi tayong gumagamit ng technology, na-acquire na natin siya. Okay, and then number four is you have to take charge. Okay, what do I mean by take charge? Yun nga, be accountable, whatever it is. Whether you're a leader or you are a staff, you have to take charge. Remember, there are no menial tasks here. Ha? So we are in a corporation. Every task is important. So we have to own our reports, own whatever it is that is assigned to us. And as much as possible, alam mo yun, be extra in life. Yung mag-add ka ng value. Ganon. Okay? So before I end my presentation, okay, next slide please. So what can we do in this age of pandemic? So as millennials, as Generation Z, being the largest workforce in our company or in the world, diba? How can we take charge? Okay, so number one, we have to make use and we have to take advantage of our being tech savvy. So we have to innovate. Kung meron ka nakikita na ma-improve yung report ng team mo, you have to say it and you have to do it. But of course, you have to let your boss know, your head know about it so that hindi din sila mabibigla. Okay? And number two, add value to reports. How can you do that? When you have this desire for frequent feedback, you always ask your boss or your head na pag nagsubmit ka ng report, huwag mong hayaan na mapunta na sa kanya. Kasi more likely, madami rin silang ginagawa, di ba? Ikaw na dapat magka-initiative na, ma'am, na yung sinabit ko po palang report sa inyo 3 days ago, 5 days ago, may feedback na po ba kayo doon? Ano pong comment niyo doon? Ganun. Ikaw na ang mag-usang magsabi. Itong mga sinasabi ko na to, ano to, based on experience din. Kasi ganyan, ginagawa ko dati. So, nangungulit talaga ako, I ask for feedback. So, kasi parang doon ko lang din malalaman kung paano ko mai-improve yung report. Ah, mali pala ako dito. Ah, ito pala yung weakness ko. So, dapat, unahin ko munang trabahuhin yung weakness ko bago na doon sa alam ko. Kasi mas madali ko na siya magagawa dahil alam ko na siya eh. So, yung sa, doon ako saan ako mahina, doon ko uunahin. Doon ako mag-aalat ng time. Okay? So, and number three, di ba, what can we do if we have this concern for social responsibility? In this age of pandemic, we have to do our part as well. At the same time, we have to, we know that we live in a bigger scheme of things, di ba? So, we have to, alam mo yun, yung we have to exercise our, how do I say this? Sige, parang, ano na lang, I will say it as blunt, as candidly, okay? Na we have to call out our officials as well, diba, in the platform that we have so that they know that kumbaga, we are not happy with how this is happening or how it is handled, being handled right now, this pandemic. Okay. So number four is we have to show ourselves to the management. Okay. So as I've noticed through the years, we are very fortunate, I think, that in this company, they, before they acquire other talents from other companies, they look within first. So this is a great opportunity for our staff, for our supervisors to show yourself out there. And you, and how can you, one way that you can show yourself to the management is by tailor fitting the reports to the audience. What do I mean by this? Okay, so nung nag-start din ako noon, parang iniisip ko, paano ba ako mapapansin? Parang ganun. Kasi dumadami na yung mga tao sa kumpanya, ganyan. Siyempre, gusto mo din naman ma-promote, gusto mo din ma-improve yung sarili mo, di ba? So, kumbaga ano na yan, yung promotion and all, yun yung goal mo. But whatever comes with it, yung package and benefits, the, these are bonuses. Kumbaga, maganda talaga na nato, yung na-improve mo yung sarili mo, na-improve yung craft mo, yung task, yung skills mo for the task, and lumalawak yung knowledge mo, di ba? So, if there's an opportunity for you to learn, even if it's quite hard or it's alam mo, uncharted territory, you go for it. You volunteer. Okay? And yung isa sa mga kumbaga strategy na ginawa ko dati is, sino ba yung magbabasa ng report ko? Sino ba yung gagamit ng report ko? So, I have to think how they think. Alam mo yung ganun, parang iniisip ko, pag ginawa ko ba to, mas maiintindihan ba kaya nila, paano ba sila? Kumbaga, nagre-research din ako kung sino yung audience ko. And then, I tailor fit my report to the audience. Hindi yung, ito kasi gusto ko, so ito na siya, ganyan. So, kumbaga, flexible ka din. Okay, and number five, let us value our work in this sobering reality that is COVID-19 pandemic. Again, number five, let us value our work in this sobering reality that is COVID-19 pandemic. So that concludes my presentation. The next slides, I would just like to show you who are my mentors and who are part of my team. Okay, so these are my mentors. Of course, these are June, kahit hindi naman kami yung talagang lagi nakakapag-interact, si Mr. Nang, si Sir JCN. But ever since, alam mo yung formative years mo as an employee, you are fresh girl, siya na yung nakikita ko. hanggang sa yung nakakasama mo na siya sa meeting. Before kasi nakikita-kita ko lang siya nung fresh grad lang ako. Ito si Sir, ganyan. Ito yung accomplishments and all. So iba pa din yung kapag, alam mo yun, yung first-hand naman na siyang nakakausap, nakaka-interact, ganun. And also, our CEO, si Miss Eileen Doyle, and for the longest time, my boss, Miss Jazz, okay? Ito pa lang, isa sa mga tip ko din, hindi ko na nasulat kanina. For mentors, it doesn't necessarily mean na kung sino lang yung direct superior mo, they will be your mentors. Of course, they will be your mentors, but you have to look for other mentors within the company as well. So, yun yung sa mga strategy number two na ginawa ko dati. At ginagawa ko pa rin naman siya. So, kaya makita niyo dito on the other side of the presentation, I have Sir Tim, Sir E.T., Sir Roger, Sir Nor, Sir Ferdy. So, sila sa land acquisition naman. And sila Sir Ferdy, sila Sir E.T. on the technical side. Kasi as business intelligence, we also have to do the land acquisition. So, nung una, di naman ako engineer or what, but I have a background on urban planning, diba? Pero hindi pa rin siya enough. So, I have to ask them and I have to learn from them. So, in a way, they're also mentoring me. Okay? So, on the next slide, ay also pala, sa legal side naman, andun sila Attorney Judy, sila Attorney Lali, Attorney Hans, and sa design, yan si Sir Jess, si Sir Arniel naman sa construction. Okay? So on the next slide, this is my team now. Okay, so as you can see, ito si Sean, yun nasa rightmost side, yung naka-gray. And si Aaron, yung katabi ko. And si Lance, yung farther left. And then si Jomari. Okay, so on the right picture naman, ito naman na kami. Ito lang, recent lang to, so naka-face mask pa kami lahat. So, ayan. And addition to our team is Gretchen. So ayan si Miss Jessie, nasa gitna. Okay, so, yun lang. And thank you very much for listening. I hope that you've learned a thing or two. And the floor is now open for questions if you have. Thank you very much.
Hi, Jen. Thank you so much for your presentation. Myself, as your generation, a millennial, I really learned a lot from you. And well, especially about leadership, no, about leadership, taking accountability. And of course, also leadership having to do with forming the people around you. I like your term, you know. The term you used is people around you, how you help form them, how you help improve them, no, and how you bring out the best in them. So that's something I'd like to baon myself one day as I, in the future, if I grow my own team, etc. It's good to take note of. And as a millennial, I can really connect with what you said, no. We really find we want to find something in common with the company. And I think here in Joy Nostalg, we're very lucky that our call to serve the homeless is something we millennials connect to. It's something we millennials feel strongly about, no?
Yes.
Something about service to help the country. And once again, Ms. Jen, thank you so much for your insights and your advice. With us this morning, we have also some panelists to share their thoughts and to also ask questions even. So I'd like to introduce them one by one. First, we have Ms. Earl Gonzalez. She is the executive housekeeper from the HDU, the hotel.
Hi, hello. Hello, Ma'am Earl.
Hi, Ms. Earl. So, Ms. Earl, we are open po to your thoughts, your comments, and questions po kung meron po.
First of all, medyo na out of place yata ako.
Hindi naman, ma'am.
But I learned a lot. Talaga, I really learned a lot. At first, I did a little review. Ano ba yung millennial na yan, tsaka yung generation? See, then I found out hindi pala ako kasama doon. Anyway, I do agree with what you shared a while ago. Now, lalo na when it comes to yung sa leadership, responsibility, and how you will be molding your team, the team under you. No, so for me, that's also very important. No? Katulad sa amin, na hindi millennial, boomer.
Millennials.
Millennial, yes, correct. So parang sa amin, it's like, ano bang role din namin? Kasi majority of the people that we're working with, I'm with the hotel industry, are millennials. Mm-hmm. And I think meron na din Gen Z. Zillennials nga daw. So, because of that, millennials nga ang dapat na approach. But because of us, na sabi mo, you know, a while ago, a little percentage of us are still in the workforce.
Yes, ma'am.
So what we can also share would be the wisdom through the years that we have learned. And we also learn from millennials and zillennials like you, lalo na yung majority are tech savvy.
Mm-hmm.
Diba? Unlike yung panahon namin, typewriter pa lang. Kaya ata ako ng shorthand. No? So, when there's a parang combination of millennials, zillennials, generation, Z, X, Y, you know, all of that, all together in a corporation, meron ino-offer yan.
Mm-hmm.
And yung group na mini-mention mo ngayon is the millennials and zillennials. I believe na ang major ano nito, impact sa industry, so workforce is yung digital, kumbaga tech savvy lahat.
Mm-hmm.
So doon naman na patungo yung ating mundo. So that's very important. And and I do agree sa mga sinabi mo. May question lang ako kayo. I always hear this, na ang mga millennials daw, don't be offended.
Yes, ma'am.
Are mga ano daw, feeling entitled.
Yes.
What do you say about that?
Ayo, sabi ko na yung sasabihin nyo.
Nabasa mo.
Alam ko. Kasi lagi pong ganun.
Bakit kaya?
Opo. Ma'am, part of it, I think, di ba, hindi ka naman di-defend yung mga millennials din. Kasi nung pong, kumbaga nung bata-bata ako, narinig ko din po yun. Tapos, syempre pag mas bata ka, pakiramdam mo, hindi ka makapagsalita. Parang ganun. So ngayon po na nasa leadership position po ako, somehow, ganyan, na meron din na po ako nililid na team. Kumbaga nasa middle ground, di ba? Sa millennial din naman ako, tapos may mga kasama din akong Gen Z and millennial na ang outspoken po talaga nila. I think natatag as entitled ang mga millennials because they speak what is on their mind. Kasi mas aware na po ang, kumbaga mas aware na din kami dahil nga lumaki kami sa digital, so makakapagbasa kami agad ng news kahit hindi kami manood ng TV, makaka-acquire kami ng digital ay ng info agad on our fingertips lang. And also, I think nasa upbringing din po yan, ma'am, na ang mga parents namin, mga Gen X po or late baby boomers, and na-experience po talaga nila yung hardship. So, nung nagka-family naman sila, ang ginawa po nila is they will do their best to send their kids to nice schools or to have a good life, ganyan po. And dun kasi makikita na din po namin habang lumalaki kami na we tend to question things na yung mga parents namin and yung generations before them, they don't question. Kasi nga po, kumbaga nasa ano din po yun, ma'am, yung kinalakhang environment. And also, I do agree na may pagka-entitled din. Kasi naiintindihan ko po yung ganun. Kaya nga po lagi kong sinasabi pag may opportunity po ako to speak. Alam po ito ni Jello, noong 2019, dun sa isang company event din po namin, na-mention ko din po yung millennials. Parang naging ano ko na siya. Gusto ko na maging, ang tag dun, yung parang naging, parang ikaw yung champion ng millennials. Parang ganun, yung ilalaban mo yung rights and yung karapatan to be heard ng mga millennials. Para hindi rin po nagkakaroon ng misconception kasi either way, you have to work with us kasi halos na po lahat ng staff ngayon, karamihan, majority are millennials and Gen Z. Diba? So how do we keep them? How do we manage them? Ganun po. And also my advice to millennials is siguro, di ba parang lagi na sinasabi kasi na huwag kayong maglipat-lipat agad ng trabaho. E paano man ako hindi maglilipat ng trabaho kung hindi ka naman nakikita na ganito, blah, blah, blah. Parang find the right balance. I think 2 to 3 years is enough if you want to jump ship. Kasi pag 6 months ka lang, kaya nababrand din ang mga millennials as entitled and ampaw, ang laki na ng hinihinging sahod dahil nakatatlong kumpanya na at the age of 25. Tapos ang skill mo, ganito lang. Doon ako na, ano kaya parang, paano naman natin mapapaganda yung pangalan natin sa mga corporation? Ganyan yung makikita nila sa atin. Diba? So dapat, yung ano muna, yung i-build mo muna din yung skills mo. Both the hard and the soft skills. Mentorship talaga yung hanapin mo. Tapos the money, it will come eh. Kapag okay ka na, kapag alam mo na yung, kapag you are confident with your set of skills na, you'll definitely go places. Kumbaga yung sa akin po, ma'am, I'm very fortunate, I'm blessed, I think, na first job ko tumo sa company. And I've been with the company for 10 years na po, kung isasama po yung sa first year ko dun sa pinanggalingan pong company ng Joy Nostalg, parang ganun po. So, ayun. I hope I answered your question, ma'am. Or kung malabo po, let me know. Feedback, sabi ko kanina.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ms. Earl and Ms. Jen. Now, speaking of being tech savvy, our next panelist naman is the digital manager from the resource management unit. So let's all welcome Ms. Risha de la Cruz. Hi, Ms. Risha. Good morning.
Hi. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, Jen. Good morning, Jello. Yan. I learned a lot during this discussion kasi as a millennial na digital head dito sa JNG, what struck me the most is yung importance ng responsibility natin and how should we take charge kasi we are lucky enough to still have a job and earning a monthly salary during this pandemic, mm-hmm. diba? So I think that's important na we should value our work kasi ang dami natanggal sa ano, trabaho and we, yun nga, lucky tayo na meron pa rin tayong job. And I also like to add yung sinabi mo, Miss Jen, na more than the monetary incentive is we as a millennial agency want to enhance our skills, no, and trainings kasi yung after graduating naman yung skills natin, it doesn't stop yung learning eh, so dapat yes. we should learn every day yun. So question lang, Miss Jen, syempre as a millennial and that digital savvy, no, how can we share our knowledge and skills dun sa mas matatandang generation like the boomers? Syempre hindi naman natin inalalahat na hindi nila alam mag yung digital world, pero 'di ba, how can we share our knowledge and skills?
Number one, patience. Kasi paulit-ulit talaga. Oo, kasi dito pag 'di ba nung kahit naman hanggang ngayon, di ba, yung mga boss ko, sabi, as in, upaulit ko talaga, tuturuan at tuturuan mo sa patience, tapos makukuha naman nila. Tapos, magbiglaan, paunti-unti, mag-introduce ko. For example, hindi kami nag-Google Drive. Ngayon, mga reports, ngayon, nag-Google Drive na kami. Marunong na sila mag-Google Drive. Kumbaga, mag-introduce ka, paunti-unti, tsaka wag mong bibiglain, tapos wag mong papahalata na nabubisit ka kapag, andan, tumang, paulit-ulit na naman tayo. Kasi, di ba, syempre, ang tendency, may hindi na sila parang ay maano na sila yung confidence nila mabababa na din, ay hindi ko na alam to, kasi ikaw na ibibigay na nila sa iyo, oh ano bang gusto mo, di ba, at least pag natutunan nila yon, malelesson din yung task mo na ikaw pang magko-compile ng ganito ganyan ganyan kasi marunong na din sila. So yun, patience, and number two, you have to build relationship first eh, tapos ano, unti-unti you introduce one, for example, one tech savvy stuff, tapos susunod na naman, wag yung madami. Pag nakita mo na na they're getting the hang of it, saka ka mag-introduce ng bago. And you'll be surprised na alam mo yung tuwang-tuwa sila kapag nakikita nila, ah, mas napapabilis pala ako pagka ganito. Kasi di ba, who wouldn't want to save time? After all, time is the most valuable resource. Ganun.
Thank you, Ms. Jen. Okay.
Mm-hmm. At saka ano pala, paano ba to? Huwag mahihiyang ano, lumapit talaga, magtanong, mag-present, ganun. Kahit na, basta alam mo yun, yung maganda, ah, ma'am, okay to pa, okay lang po ba, ganyan. Kasi minsan naiisip natin, naku, dadagdag na naman sa task ko, eh ano naman, di ba? Kung makakatulong naman siya, tsaka dun ka nga mapapansin eh, di ba? Yun yung magandang pagpapapansin, I think. Kumbaga strategy. Kesa yung kung ano-ano pagpapansin ang gawin mo. Diba? Yun na lang. Idaan mo sa added value. Kasi syempre mga boss natin with their ano work experience of 15 years, 20 years, as in talaga yung lalim ng alam nila. Iba talaga. Kasi kumbaga, ang dami na lang sitwasyon na napagdaanan. Minsan umuulit na lang yung sitwasyon. Ang napaparaanan na nila. Ngayon, ang gagawin mo as a tech savvy part of the team is to make their life easier. Yun talaga. Tapos, when you clear the path for them, you're also clearing a path for yourself. Mapapansin at mapapansin ka nila because of the added value in your work. Pero minsan mag-uulat ka. Pero okay, yun talaga. Part of the job.
Yes. Thank you, Ms. Jen.
Okay. Thank you then, Risha.
Okay. Thank you, Risha. Thank you, Jen. And now for our last panelist, we have a project officer from the FDU, the Foundation Development Unit. Let's all welcome Ms. Myra Vega. Hi, Myra.
Hello, Myra. Good morning.
Hello. Good morning po. So yun po, first of all, thank you po, Ms. Jen, for your very interesting po talaga yung topic na we are tackling responsibility with regards to our intergenerational factor. So parang when I was listening to Ms. Jen, parang nakikita ko rin yung, parang ito yung reflection ko talaga. Kasi honestly po, it's my fourth employer na, tama ba? Yes, JNG is my fourth employer na. So parang sabi ko, nagising bigla ako na, ganito pala yung parang view on some or maybe most of us millennials niya. So, a very interesting thing niya. So, actually, yun yung first question ko sana na, ano na, pero nasagot niya na earlier, Miss Jen, about jumping ship nga. And what should millennials consider ba before jumping ship? But since nasagot na siya, I would go on to my next.
May add lang ako, Myra.
Ah, sige po.
Ako. Kasi paano ba't mo sasabihin? I think, kumbaga, millennials and Gen Z jump ship because they are not heard at the same time. On our part naman, since we are young pa or what, hindi rin tayo nagsasabi. So, dapat magsabi ka, bago ka umalis, try mo muna kausapin yung boss mo. Sabihin mo talaga, you have to show yourself, you have to be heard. Kumbaga, last hurrah, bago ka umalis, ito muna, para wala kang regrets. Kasi mamaya, nag-aantay lang pala din yung boss. May hindi rin naman niya alam, hindi ka naman nagsasalita. Parang ganun. Alam niyo, sinishare ko. This is an experience din. Pero buti hindi ako natutuloy yung umalis dati. Kasi ganyan din. Parang, ano ba, alis na ba ako? Kasi parang di man ako napapakinggan or what. Ganyan. Pero yun pala, kapag nag-aantay lang din yung boss ko na magsabi. Kasi di, on my end din, hindi ako nagsasalita. Tapos ano ko na, dapat pala dito nagsasabi, nag-feedback, ganyan, ganyan. So dun ko na ano yung, dapat ano na magkaroon ko na ng initiative talaga to go to them, to ask them. Kasi dati parang isipin mo, kapag naging boss ako, ito na lang gagawin ko, okay na ako. Ay, hindi din. Ang dami pala, sobra. Parang doon mo maintindihan din yung boss mo dati, kaya hindi kanya talaga na yung mga simple things na gusto mo, hindi niya mabigay sa'yo. Kasi hindi mo sinasabi dahil ang dami pa niyang ibang mas malalaking task na kailangan gawin. Pero once you say it to them, you open up, mas magiging ano na, yung communication niyo together, mas madali na yung working relationship, I assure you, when you communicate talaga. Sana at Myra, last mo na to, huwag ka na mag-jump.
Hindi naman po ako nag-i-imply na less, pero yun nga po, parang na-realize ko lang na, so, may ganito palang take on millennials on with regards to jump. So, thank you po, ma'am, dun sa advice niyo po on that. So, another thing na po, if mabibigyan pa ako ng time. So, with regards po dito sa age natin, na parang since millennials are very outspoken and meron tayong social media for that. So, with regards naman po on, parang we always like to take responsibility on issues of national importance. Kaya, like po yung nangyayari dito sa pandemic. We are very outspoken on that. And minsan, most of the comments, personal experience na nakikita ko is actually most of them medyo out of line or it's not relating to what the topic is really is at hand. So, ano po kaya ma'am ang magiging advice mo for these millennials na very outspoken sa social media on how they should be talaga reacting on issues, especially on issues of national importance?
Okay. Thank you, Myra. Sige. I will answer that as candidly parang kanina. No? First of all, check mo muna control. Kasi control yan, don't feed the troll. Kikita sila pag nireplyan mo eh. So, wag, don't engage. Diba? Kung makita mo naman na sensible person, yung totoong tao talaga siya, hindi siya troll or hindi siya paid farm, whatsoever. Kung you interact on a sensible way, pag yung sagot niya, mga tirada niya na out of line na, eh don't deadma na, the art of deadmatology, parang ganun. Huwag mo mapansinin. Kasi kung troll yan, kikita lang siya sa'yo. Di ba, alam mo yun, they are paid with the amount of responses that they get. Kaya nga sabi, di ba, starve the trolls. Huwag na, huwag, don't engage. Ngayon, kung ano sila, I think is, check mo muna din if the source of the news, if it's fake or not. Kung mapapansin nyo dun sa mga slides ko earlier, may mga sources ako sa baba, references. Kasi, as in our nature of work, we respect data. So first, you have to verify the source if it's fake or if it's authentic, if it's news talaga. And then, you have to be responsible on your own social media platform. Okay, so yun nga, as usual, lagi, think before you click. So far, di pa naman ako na papasok. Ganun, sana yun. Kumbaga, you have to choose your battle. Hindi yung lahat na lang ng issue anuhin mo kasi nakaka-stress talaga. Mm-hmm. Diba? Oh, you have to do your part as for your own mental health din and you have to be aware pa din. Kasi yung mga pagiging outspoken natin, alam mo, sa dinami-dami ng mga past issues, meron siyang din nagagawa. Diba? Kailan ko ba mag-mention ng iba? Huwag na. Alam na naman na natin yun.
So, Ma'am Jen, thank you
for your battle, girl.
Thank you, Ms. Myra, and thank you, Ms. Jen. And before we end, I'd like to remind everyone that we have an attendance sheet, which I will post right now in our chat group. So please feel free to, please fill it up, okay? We have a comment here from Ms. Chrissy Victoriano. While millennials can benefit from the wisdom of mentors, it is also a must that they know what they want and guiding values. Otherwise, this will just be easier to go with the flow or just ship or jump ship when things don't necessarily go their way. Having that clear destination in mind can serve as an easy decision guide or how to pursue one's life and career. No, so I comment here of Ms. Chrissy, the reminder, react Ms. Jen said a while ago, nemo. Especially when you said, Ms. Jen, we millennials, we may seem entitled because we want to be heard, and not being heard can cause people to jump ship. But of course, it's good also to make ourselves heard. Dapat may effort from our end to reach out to our superiors, no?
Yes, so agree. And yung sense of community and purpose. Kung wala talaga, baka hindi talaga yun yung kumpanya na para sa iyo. Pero diba, on your end, dapat isipin mo din. Tama yung sinabi din ni Ms. Chrissy na ikaw, alam mo din kung ano yung objective mo, tsaka alam mo din yung kung anong goal mo.
Thanks. Okay, so thank you again, Ms. Jen, for your very meaningful talk. I learned a lot, and I'm sure we all learned a lot from you. It's good to hear this talk from a young leader as a, like yourself, no, a fellow millennial. I hope we're still considered young. I think we are, no? So again, thank you, Ms. Jen.
So pasok pa
correct, tayo. Correct. So, talagang pasok pa tayo.
Mga sa early 30s pa naman tayo, Jen. So okay lang.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. Mag-30 pa lang ako. Sorry naman. Okay. So thank you. So thank you again, Ms. Jen. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Thank you also, Ms. Myra, Ms. Earl, and Ms. Fisha for being here.
Thank
and thanks to all of you for joining us in our Wellness Wednesday. Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Myra. Thank you, Risha. Thank you, Ms.
Thanks, everyone. Have a great day.
Bye-bye.